Hello and welcome to this innovation coffee break. Here at dSPACE, we work hard to make your model-based development experience a little bit better every single day. Today, I will show you how all the pieces of model-based development fit together. For this, I have chosen an e-motor application. The task is to create the computation logic to drive a brushless machine. And we use MATLAB Simulink and TargetLink to develop the model, run mill simulations, and finally create an executable specification to use in software development. The main challenges when undertaking such a control project are, in this case, first of all, to meet the performance requirements. This is an eDrive application. You need to match the rotation speed. In this case, it runs at 100 microseconds for the fastest task. Then you need to map the model to the software architecture in the end. You need to specify the inputs and outputs, and you need to implement the software architecture. We use TargetLink to take care of the actual code generation, taking care of the coding step. Also, this ensures performance requirements are met because TargetLink will generate highly performant production C code. We use the TargetLink data dictionary to map the model to the architecture and to implement the software architecture. In TargetLink, this is the recommended way of specifying production code settings, and it allows you to change the production code settings independently of the model. So if you change your hardware, all you need to do is change this lean configuration set in the TargetLink data dictionary. And finally, we use TargetLink's model-in-the-loop and software-in-the-loop simulation capabilities to verify that the generated production code meets the executable specification directly on the host PC. Let us take a look at the final goal that I want to achieve. Here, I have brought with me a motor development board. There's a microcontroller on it. In this case, it's from STMicroelectronics, a Cortex M3-based processor. This controller drives a MOSFET controller IC, which drives the inverter stages that you can see here. And those are actually capable of driving much larger loads than the small servo that is here on this board for demonstration purposes. On this board, I can now switch between three different controller modes. There's a talk mode, which I reach by pressing once, a speed mode, and a position mode. And let me go to the speed mode at this point, start the motor, and then I can use this potentiometer to actually set the speed and vary the set point at this stage. So what do we need to do to implement this in software? Let's take a look at the model. And you will be able to see that there are four main elements. At the center of this whole task is the field generation unit. This is what creates the currents in order to drive the coils and to create the motor. Then we have the three controllers corresponding to the three operation modes that I've mentioned, the torque controller, the speed controller, and the position controller. And you can already see the benefits of model-based development because in this very expressive graphical language, it becomes immediately clear that those three controllers are hierarchical and work by setting a set point for the underlying controllers. On the bottom left, we have a state manager. This is a state chart-based component which actually implements the switch through the modes that happens when I press the button. And also an important part is the position detection unit here, which actually goes on to measure the current position of the motor. So let's go into the model itself to take a closer look at a couple of special things where I want to highlight a couple of benefits of using model-based development and showcase a couple of ways of working with TargetLink. In the model, I would like to focus on two main aspects. The first aspect is the mapping of the model to the software architecture. And the second one is the separation of code and model by using the target link data dictionary. If you take a look at the model, you can see that the functions are each put into several individual subsystems, and they are what we call target link subsystems. And in target link, you can now work with them individually, and they are listed as individual items and entities in the target link main dialog. So that means you can, for each of those controllers individually, do things like generate code, switch to simulation mode, and so on. The particular application and importance in this model is the sheer performance requirements. You have this basic PWM controller, which is running at 100 microseconds and already taking up 10% of the processor's power. So that means it will be hard to also run all those outer controllers at the same time. And on the other hand, you don't need to do this, so you can actually run them on different time cycles. And by putting them into separate subsystems, you can actually achieve the target link generates also individual files for them, like this postcontroller.c or the rpmcontroller.c here, with individual functions. And you can now map those different functions also to different interrupts or different cycle times in your embedded operating system. The second thing I want to show is how to separate the code configuration from the actual model. And to this, I can, for example, choose in this RPM controller this constant, which is also calibratable. So you want to calibrate it, and that means that typically there are requirements to put them into specific memory sections. How this is done depends on the compiler that you use. Now, how to do this in TargetLink? The nice thing is, in the model, all you do is double-click on the block and select the suitable variable class for this variable and for all others. This exists once. And this exists in the TargetLink data dictionary and specifies all kinds of properties of the generated code. It's writable, for example. It should be exported to A2L. You can optimize it. And it has a code decoration set attached, which specifies how exactly to achieve the mapping to a particular segment in the processor. Now, if you need to change the processor and you need to change the syntax, all you need to do is change this one setting in the data dictionary, click OK, generate code a second time, and you're done. So those are two of the typical mechanisms that you need to apply before generating code. Once you're ready, you can generate the code. And as I've told you, this model not only contains the yellow controller parts, but also plant model, so you can do closed loop simulation and validation. Let me show this. At the moment, all those subsystems are in model in the loop mode, and I have selected exactly one signal, the one that I'm interested in for logging. So this is the plot. Let me fit this a little bit better. And this is the reference that I want to meet. So this is the rotor speed, the output of the RPM controller. So let me switch this to software in the loop simulation. And now I simulate again. And since this RPM controller uses fixed point data types, I expect to see a quantization error, and I want to verify if this quantization error is acceptable. So you can already see that there's an error here, and I can also switch to a detailed plot view here, which contains just those. And in the third step, I can also go into a view where I can see the deviation to other signals. So for this particular signal, I'm happy, and I can now repeat this for other signals, or even do this automatically for all the signals based on different inputs and outputs. So what does this mean? Where do we go? Let me summarize. I've shown you a complete motor control application. Of course, this is a small example, which has the benefit of making it complete. Also, it's available as an education kit, so you can buy it for a small fee from dSPACE and test it out yourself. our customers do bigger projects. A couple of the most interesting ones are selected here. In this demo, I've shown you the benefits of applying model-based design. And I've shown you the benefits of using TargetLink for code generation and of using the TargetLink data dictionary to separate your code specification from your actual model. So, benefit from our decades of knowledge and experience. Get in touch now and let us show you what we can do for you.
dSPACE, your partner in simulation and validation.